Of course, every year at D-RATS, researchers attempt to expand their knowledge from previous years, and this testing season is no different. For this go-round, the D-RATS team upped the ante and brought two rovers to help them prepare for future missions.
The SEV rovers, or space exploration vehicles, are revolutionary spacecraft that will help humans explore much more than we ever could before. Building on lessons learned from the Apollo mission rovers, NASA has created these pressurized vehicles to help our astronauts do more meaningful research in a much more comfortable setting. For example, when the Apollo-era astronauts wanted to use their rovers, they would first have to go through a lengthy suit-up process, then spend as much as 8 hours exploring on one long spacewalk. This approach had several downfalls. First, spacesuits both then and now are very bulky, cumbersome, and can be painful to use over a long period of time. Secondly, astronauts only have a small amount of oxygen that they can carry on their backs, limiting the amount of time they can spend on the planetary surface. Luckily for crews of the future, the new SEVs were built with those limitations in mind. Future astronauts can now sit comfortably in a shirt-sleeve environment and drive the rover within inches of a rock or item of interest. If they do need to get out and explore, they can simply climb through a hatch into a suit that attached to the back of the vehicle. Within minutes, they can be on the surface exploring. The process of getting into their spacesuits and out of the vehicle is now faster than ever, enabling multiple short excursions as an alternative to one long one. Of course, another huge benefit of the SEVs is the mobility they provide. Astronauts driving these vehicles can explore as much as 200 kilometers in any direction, greatly increasing the scientific opportunities during the mission. To help prepare for these future missions, planners at D-RATS brought out two vehicles and crews to work in tandem with each other. Complex docking maneuvers, communication tests, and numerous other activities were done to help validate mission procedures and help planners find any unforeseen problems early on. Because all of this testing and experimentation is being done in the real-world environment here on Earth, mission planners can make changes and tweaks to the vehicles to make sure they are ready for missions into space. The same technology that will someday be used by astronauts in space could also lead to better, more efficient transportation back here on Earth, too.